is your mother talking. Do you hear me? What it is you're ripping in there? Please, not the guest towels. Please come out. 100 people are waiting downstairs. It's your bar mitzvah party. You're 13 years old now. Come out and be a man. What are you ripping?
I'm tearing up savings bonds.
The doorbell, I'm coming. Yoo-hoo, I'm coming. I hope to God that's him. Don't worry, son. Help is on the way. Hello.
Mrs. Weitzman?
Yes?
How do you do? I believe you sent for me. Here's my card.
Rabbi Jessel. Exorcisms and circumcisions. Three chairs, no waiting. Group rates available. Yeah, you're the man I need.
That's what I thought. Now then, please remind me of what you need. Circumcising or exorcising? One time, many, many years ago, I got confused between two clients. Snipped a little skin off a devil's nose, then caused a little boy's pee-pee to take leave of his body.
Exorcism, if you don't mind. My son is possessed.
Just what is it makes you think your boy is possessed by the devil? Or as we say in the trade, the dibbick.
Well, it's the night of his bar mitzvah party, and he's in the toilet ripping up savings bonds.
No, that is not necessarily possession by the devil.
No?
He might have figured out what those bonds will be worth in 10 years. What with inflation and the price of herring? Any other signs of physical damage?
Yeah, he woke up this morning, came into the living room, and broke a pen and pencil set.
That's not too bad.
Over his father's nose.
Ah, a definite sin. Many, many years ago, the Bible taught that a young 13-year-old boy should do two things.
Mm-hmm.
Honor thy father,
mm-hmm.
and stay clear of Gentile girls until he gets to college.
Listen. Can you exorcise this devil?
You don't think I've got a license for nothing, do you? For a man to be an exorcist, he must have two qualifications.
Mm-hmm.
He must have seen the devil,
mm-hmm.
and he must have a thorough knowledge of the drapery business.
You've seen the devil?
Once in Las Vegas. My brother-in-law Herb pulled some strings and got me a table.
Uh-huh. Listen, will you help, man boy?
I don't come cheap. $500.
$500?
All right, you drive a hard bargain, $180.
Listen, does it have to be cash or can I make a pledge?
If you pledge it, it's $6.95. Oh, for $4.95, I can plant a tree for you.
I'll take the tree. Listen, there's the bathroom.
I don't have to go.
No, my son is in there.
Then I'll wait my turn.
Rabbi, are you senile?
Certainly not. And I haven't been for years.
Many, many years.
That's right. Now then, what is your son's name?
Kevin.
Well, no wonder. If I had to go through life a Kevin Weitzman, I'd break a pen and pencil set, too. Why is it that all I see nowadays are Sean Feldmans and Lance Shapiro's, but never a Sol Flanagan? Your kid's problem is he doesn't know who the devil he is. Now I'll begin the exorcism.
Mm-hmm.
Remember, Mrs. Weitzman, once the devil leaves him, your son will never know he was once possessed. You'll be a normal, happy boy, afraid to eat pork and kiss a Gentile girl. Baruch atoy, many, many years ago. Kevin, come out of the bathroom and join the rest of the guests. There's hot hors d'oeuvres and cold hors d'oeuvres. Come on, devil, get out of there. Shoo, come on. Come on, devil, get the hell out of there.
Why, Mr. Jessel, he's coming out. You're a savior.
Hello, Mother. Well, I guess I'll go and thank the guests for all my lovely gifts on this, the most important day of my life.
What? And go downstairs without washing your hands first? Bite your tongue.